Going back to our story in the Philippine government's efforts to send back overseas Filipino workers back to the provinces, we now have on the line Philippine Labor Secretary Silvestre Bello III. Secretary, good afternoon and thank you so much for taking our call. It's so nice to talk to you once again.
Hello, good afternoon, Rica.
Hi, sir. The president has ordered to bring everyone, the OFWs, those in the OF facilities, all 24,000 of them, home within the whole week. But most of them do not still have the test results. I'm just curious, Secretary. Is this the right thing for us to be rushing everybody, bringing home everybody to their provinces, knowing that this might result to another surge of COVID cases?
Because I have to make this very clear. Mm-hmm. When you're referring to the 24,000 OFWs, mm-hmm. These 24,000 OFWs already went through the health protocol of 14-day quarantine. Mm-hmm. And then after that, the PCR swab testing and another testing from the Bureau of Quarantine. Mm-hmm. And they have been found negative of COVID-19. Mm-hmm. So these 24,000 OFWs are all negative COVID-19. Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Already all of them have been tested.
Problem.
All right. Okay. Sir, have they already received their certifications of clearances to return home?
How's that? So we are bringing them home. The 24,000, we will try to bring them home in 3 to 5 days. Mm-hmm. Although the president said that we have 1 week to do that, we will try to deliver them to their respective final destination in a shorter time, because we know and we can feel how our OFWs have been missing their relatives and family. So we want them to go home to their mahal, mga minamahal sa buhay. Mm-hmm. We want to fast track the transport of our OFWs to their final destination.
Mm-hmm. Sir, so far of the 24,000, how many numbers have already been sent home? And also, may I know, who are we coordinating with to help assist them with their transport?
Well, the one in charge of this is, of course, the OWA, the PCG, the DOTR, and also the LTFRB and other government agencies. But yesterday, we started bringing them home, and we succeeded in chartering 18 flights and then another 21 bus transportation for our 2,972 OFWs. So, mm-hmm. nakauwi na po yung 2,972. Mm-hmm. We were short. Our target was 8,000, but we ran short of bus facilities, and then there were some problem in the with the flights. But then, mm-hmm. hopefully today we can recover, because aside from air transportation and land transportation, we have to make use of the sea transportation.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. All right. Sir, we are also expecting 62,000 more OFWs coming home. Now, with the government funds dwindling, where will we be getting funds to provide assistance for our OFWs?
You mean funds, Rica?
Mm-hmm.
Well, we have funds. Although the ones arriving is not actually 62,000. We are expecting for the month of May and June, 44,000.
Mm-hmm.
The 62,000 refers to our stranded OFWs in different parts of the world.
Mm-hmm.
But only 44,000 are scheduled to arrive by May and June.
All right, sir. Thank you so much for that clarification. So 44,000 expected to return within the next 2 months. That is a lot. That's a big surge of OFWs coming home. Now, sir, I'm just looking at how we're going to be able to accommodate them. Will the 24,000, once everybody has been sent home, is this the facilities we have, is this enough to accommodate all those coming in? And also, looking also at the testings for the COVID,
yes,
the COVID tests for the OFWs as well.
Yes, Rica, that's why there is a hurry for us to bring home the 24,000. 1,000 so that we can accommodate the 44,000. However, there is another procedure. It has been decided that those who have different destinations, like destinations where there are existing quarantine facilities, they may go direct to these airports. Like, for example, in Cebu, where they have quarantine facilities, these OFWs can be flown back directly to Cebu and probably to Iloilo, Rayam de Oro, and probably Davao City. And even, Clark City is open to accept OFWs who can be immediately subjected to a 14-day quarantine. So we will not have a lot of problem of accommodation here in Metro Manila.
Secretary, some officials of the local governments have also been vocal about the unexpected thing that President Duterte said, his issuance of order to direct every OFWs that we have home. Now, I'm just curious, how are we addressing the concerns of our local government officials with regard to the safety of their constituents as well?
I think, Rika, what the president was referring to are the 24,000 OFWs who will be transported to their final destination. And there should be no problem with our local government units because all these 24,000 are established and cleared to be negative of COVID-19. So there is no problem. What we are looking forward to are the 44,000. So they will have to go directly to their places of final destination only if there are quarantine facilities in their places.
All right. Finally, Secretary, before I let you go, you've advised OWA to resurrect the Balik Pilipinas, Balik Livelihood program for our returning OFWs. But this would be another chunk of financial burden for the government. How are we going to be able to sustain this? Will there be changes in the program implementation, sir?
We got no problem because the OWA has a national reintegration program for our OFWs. So they have funds for that. So I hope that they will not run of funds, but they have programs for our returning OFWs. Ever since, this has been an ongoing program for all of the OFWs. When they come home and stay permanently, they're provided with the integration program, which may be in the form of financial assistance, livelihood assistance, scholarship programs, and alternative employment options.
But, sir, these programs that you mentioned are only all for our OFWs. I'm also concerned about the non-OFWs, the disenfranchised employees, the workers who are left with no jobs to return home to return to when the COVID, when the restrictions ease.
Well, with respect to other employees, there are also programs for that, Rika, but we treat the OFWs separately.
All right. Okay. Thank you so much for your time, Secretary Silvestre Bello III of the Labor Department.
Okay. Thank you, Rika.
Thank you, sir.
Nice
good day.
To you.